I'm playing Henry Jekyll and Mr. Hyde in Jekyll and Chains. I don't think Tool would be considered grunge, but if it is, I'd say Tool would beat out everyone. Right now, at this point, my favorite song to sing is Man in the Box, because I think that, I like the original version, but I like what we've done with it, the interpretation that we're taking with it. It's just, it's a lot of fun to sing, too. Sir Psycho Sexy is a lot of fun to do. And I'm a huge, huge Nine Inch Nails fan. So to be able to do Head Like a Bull, it's kind of like Christmas morning. I'm excited to do Jekyll and Chains. The music, of course, is just a lot of fun. I like the idea of where we're taking the show and kind of putting it in the 90s. I think it's just a great period of time for music. I dressed mooey grunge in the 90s. I had the Doc Martens, I had several, I had flannel, and of course you always tied it around your waist. There were certain times like I would try to find places where it was appropriate to pose, like Chris Cornell from Soundgarden. Like I'd see him like, that's an interesting pose, I'm gonna try to work that in. And so you'd be like, this is natural, this is normal. Chris Cornell did this on a cover of a magazine. I prepared for this role by panicking. I've been trying very hard to prepare for the role. I've been studying the David Hasselhoff version of this and trying not to do anything from that. I've also been reading the original Jekyll and Hyde and trying not to fall asleep from it. So I'm just trying to avoid anything that they did in their versions. I think the people should come see the show because I'm in it. First and foremost, I think you should come see it for the music. If you guys have seen any of the other shows that we've done, either The Villains and Vixens or Something We Give, This Way Rocks, the band is so incredible. Leave the kids at home. We're dealing with some pretty upsetting themes in this, from murder, rape, drug use, abusive relationships. So it's a great artistic piece, but it can be very heavy. So for anyone where that's an issue for you, we just want to give you a heads up on that. But there's still comedic moments. There's still laughs. Does anybody remember laughter? Yeah. Jekyll and Chains opens March 17th. It runs through March 26th at the Headwaters Theater.